In this tutorial, I'll show you how to auto-add captions to your videos using Camtasia's speech-to-text. Welcome to this video, my name is David and I hope you're well wherever you are around the world. Now, for this video, I'm using Camtasia 2025 as of June 30th, 2025. So, I've got Camtasia open and I also have the video I want to add auto-captions to using the Camtasia speech-to-text feature. Now, just drag and drop it inside the import media section here and you can see it, it's available. I'll just add it to the timeline now, but you can also still drag all your media to the timeline as you'd like. Now, I'll just zoom to fit right there. That's the whole video. It's about 2 minutes, 42 seconds. Now, the next step now is to auto-add captions to this video. I'll click on more. If your window is not big enough for you to see all the menu items, captions is right here. I'll click on it, and from here, it goes directly to the dynamic captions feature if you are on Windows. But if you click on the CC, and this is what we want, there is a gear icon right here. If I click on it, you'll see the option to sync captions from a transcript, import captions, export captions, speech to text. Now, this is what we need, and I'll click on that. And once I do that, you'll get a new prompt, speech to text. Captions are created from audio on the timeline. Select the timeline range to use. So either the entire timeline, that is all the items or the media in your timeline, or selected media. Use only selected audio media on the timeline. I'll go for the entire timeline. And from here, you'll see another prompt or a Camtasia disclosure, Camtasia AI disclosure. Do you want to enable audio transcription? Camtasia uses whisper.cpp to convert speech into text captions. Your spoken audio is processed by AI on your computer, so it doesn't leave your computer to go anywhere, which is a really a big plus. Now, you can change this setting at any time in the editor preferences. I'll click on enable, and it's going to prepare audio for transcription and then begin transcribing my audio to text. You're going to see the progress here in percentage as it processes your audio into captions. So we just give it a couple of seconds, and obviously depending on how long your audio file is, it may take a while, so you may need to go get a coffee or something. Now it's already done and you can already see the captions right here. And if I play this, in this tutorial I'll show you how to use ChatGPT to translate text into other languages. So one thing you'll notice is you'll need to do a couple of cutting up slightly. If I go back to the start, it starts really well and kicks off with the captions where they need to begin at the audio waveform. But then you realize all this text is too bulky for somebody and you may need to tighten up a little bit what is being said here. So I can listen a little bit.
Use ChatGPT to translate text into other languages.
So we can do away with the welcome here and just cut it at around there. Just click on this and press on S to split. Once you do that, you can come to the first, just double click on it and get right inside here and remove the welcome so that you have something that is more or less, or actually you can actually split it some more.
In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use.
I'll actually just cut it at ChatGPT and then just double click on this, how to use. And then just put a comma here in this tutorial. I'll show you how to use, and then come right here and then do ChatGPT capital C text into other languages, and then put a full stop right here. So as you can see,
how to use ChatGPT to translate text into other languages.
So looks good. If I continue, now we have the welcome. So I can just remove this section here and you'll see.
Just welcome to this video. My name is David and I hope you're well wherever you are around the world now.
So we can go up to here, up to now. Captioning sometimes can be a really kind of painstaking process because you need to make sure that everything lines up and you don't have too much text on screen. So we can join these together, merge with previous caption right there. And once we do that, you'll see that if we actually look at everything here, You'll see now we have a lot of text going on again. So we have to think logically.
Welcome to this video.
I can actually cut it from welcome to this video. And then we remove this section right there.
Welcome to this video.
And then we remove the welcome to this video in this particular section. Just double click, brings up the caption box, cut it off. We can do shift enter to bring well down here. And then if we play this.
Yes. Welcome to this video. My name is David and I hope you're well wherever you are around the world.
Around the world. That's the correction. The world. So it's more or less a back and forth in that particular process. And then you can keep doing that. Now here we have to begin at now.
I've got ChatGPT open, it's a free version, and I do.
As you can see, now everything looks okay for the first section of it. So it's more or less of a repetitive process of ensuring that your text syncs and also there's not too much text on screen. So if we can play the first part of the edit we've done.
In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use ChatGPT to translate text into other languages. Welcome to this video. My name is David and I hope you're well wherever you are around the world.
The pacing is good, the text looks good on screen, and obviously if you click on this one text here, you can bring down this particular option to do the different stylings you may want. For example, you may want that text to be like that, and then something like that, so that when somebody is reading, they don't have to kind of scan from this end or lack of uniformity in the text right there. So that is how you use that auto caption feature, and then once you're done, you can actually click on the gear icon and export the captions. If you click on that and export them to your folder of choice as, let's say, david.srt, save as type, or you can also choose a SAMI caption file. SRT is accepted almost anywhere, so I'd recommend you do that and click on save. So you have a saved copy of the SRT, and then you can work on this as well. So that's it for this video. That is how you can use the Camtasia speech-to-text feature powered by OpenAI's Whisper to automatically caption your videos for free. That's it for this video. I hope it's of value to you. Thanks for watching.